Hello, and welcome back to Super Mario Galaxy for Nintendo Wii, and today we're actually going to be going to the center of the universe because I can't actually do anything else before completing the game. I need to be able to complete the game to, well, I need to complete the game to unlock the purple coin challenges. So what I'm going to do is talk to Rosalina if she'll talk to me, and then we're going to go to the center of the universe and do the Bowser level. At the end of the episode, episode 19, I actually thought that the center of the universe on the little map was the islands that you go to with the green swing star, but that isn't the case at all. The center of the universe, for whatever reason, is at the bottom of the map, so it kind of confused me. I actually had to look at stuff online as well to make sure that there was no way I could do purple coins before doing Center of the Universe, and nope, they designed it so you have to beat the game before you can get all 120 stars, which is weird. I guess it's because of a countdown thing that happens after you beat this section. And since the last episode, I've changed batteries in a Wiimote, so it should be completely fine. I hope. Sometimes the Wiimote just has issues in general, but hopefully it's fine. Anyway, Center of the Universe. There we go. Or the Fate of the Universe. So this is the last Bowser level that we're gonna get, and to be honest, I think Mario Galaxy 2's Final Bowser is a lot more impressive, I guess, in some ways, than what they did with this one. Like, the music's good and everything in here, but it's not astounding. Like, there's been better music in a series. I also kinda need the Star Bits. It's just, gonna have to quickly get a Wiimote up the screen next time. Instead of me, you know, hoping that I'm gonna be able to pull it up in time. Just the way that I have my Wiimote is kinda awkward at times. And I have enough Star Bits to do any sort of, like, quest that may come up on this. Although, this is the only star, so let's just try not to die there. This is the only star, so I'm just collecting star bits for the Hungry Lumas, I guess. There's a life mushroom over there as well, which I'm gonna try and get. It did not mean to fall in there, but actually that's not a life mushroom, that's just a normal mushroom. Okay, for whatever reason, the ice blocks disappear, so we're not getting the normal mushroom, or the normal life mushroom. One up, is what I'm trying to say. Jeez, okay, I think I'm dead? I don't see a way out. Never mind. I wasn't sure if I could get out, but apparently I could. It may be faster to take the death, but I refused to give up. So spinning the Wiimote kind of saved me. Taking additional damage for almost no reason at all. Barely made that. Just have to be careful here. I need a coin or something. I'm gonna die very quickly in this section. Yep. I knew it was coming, just because, like, there's so many enemies and things that can hurt you in that section that it was so obvious that I was gonna die. There we go, 133 star bits now. Just have to avoid that Bulbasaur and I'll be fine. I'm gonna wait for it. Oh, I was that away, like that far away from health. If I managed to make it here, I would have been fine. That's kind of disappointing in some ways. I'm not going for that one up. Okay, I believe I'm fine. I just have to go to this side and progress forward. That bullet bill is gonna hit me if I went at that point. Now I should be fine though. I just have to get onto the middle here. I'm gonna have to jump to these sinking platforms. Then over here. I believe I should be fine as long as I just avoid the bullet bills. I didn't mean to get hit, but I'm gonna grab that coin because I actually want to keep my health. I don't know why the gravity is kind of messed up there. It won't let you go over that little bump in the ground very easily. I don't think you actually fight Junior, I think you just fight Bowser. It's been a long time since I've done this part though. Okay, he just shoots cannonballs to destroy the ground that you're walking on. Not really a surprise at all. Final confrontation with Bowser, I believe. I don't think there's another one in the game. Okay, I just need to hit him when he comes to attack me, I guess. Yeah, I thought I was gonna get hit there. I didn't really see a way I was getting away from that. Oh, he becomes a ball. Great. How do I hit him? Yeah. Okay, fair enough. So I just have to quickly hit him. When he is in that ball state. I guess I can only hit his head though, since that's the only thing exposed. I kinda got lucky there, I think. Is that phase over already? That seems kinda odd. I figured that was what I had to do, just wait until he was really spitting fire or attacking me and counter hit him with one of these things. Okay, he's gonna go crazy for a bit, then when he stops. Yeah, okay. It looked like I took damage there, but it seemed like I'm fine. I haven't took a hit. Well, actually I have. I took one at the beginning. I just healed. Don't know why I thought I didn't. I guess it's just because of my life meter. So do I just avoid him until he does this? Yeah. Then hit him again. Do I have to do this 3 times? Yeah, I guess so. Oh, the fireballs are attacking me as well. I never even noticed them until I almost hit, well, I did get hit by one, but until they were really close to me, I didn't even notice they were there. It's right there, if we can just hit him again on this side. There we go. Huh, I fought 3 times is what we need to do, but I guess not. That was really simple and easy. The annoying thing is that the rest of this is going to be credits, and because it's the credits, there isn't really much to do or talk about. I have to kind of keep them in. I mean, I guess we can just talk a little bit about the game and what I thought about it. Or what I think about the game, since we're not really done yet. I still have more stars to collect, because I don't know what star number this is anymore. But this is the last Grand Star. And then you get a cutscene for her next, like, 10 minutes or so. It's just fine, like... there haven't been that many cutscenes in the game. It's still really impressive to me how they managed to get, like, this video footage of Wii. The Wii is such an underpowered system. Like, in its generation, the Xbox 360 and the PS3, like, blew it out of the water, and it's impressive what Nintendo were able to accomplish with their hardware. Obviously, it's not a 720p or 1080p system, but it did a lot for what little chips it had inside of it. For those that don't know, the Wii is basically two GameCubes stuck together. It's basically double the strength of a GameCube, which isn't that strong. But even then, Nintendo managed to get a lot of pretty stuff out of the GameCube too. Graphically, however, I believe it has the same processor, like GPU, as a GameCube. I don't think it was that much stronger than a GameCube. It wasn't two of them stuck together. The processing power, however, was two GameCubes stuck together, and I think it had double the RAM as well. I don't know for sure. I'm not a tech expert when it comes to hardware, but it definitely was like twice the strength of a GameCube in some aspects, or maybe all. And Mario's dead because a big black hole is eating the universe. Such a strange, like, image. Thank you. What I feel like is implied is that technically you're reborn into essentially parallel timeline, I guess, in a sense of like different events will happen to Mario that he didn't experience before or wouldn't have normally, I guess, since like they died and like kind of came back to life. I'm not really sure what Nintendo's getting at. They're always very vague with their storyline implications. Since the Lumas obviously fits the universe with the black hole thing, or saved it somewhat. So, this game's been interesting and fun to do so far. I forgot what the games were actually like. I just kind of shunned them for the past couple of years because, and they're not as deep and as creative as some of the other Mario games are, like 64 and Sunshine. They don't accomplish as much. However, they are creative in their own way, and it's interesting. And they're gorgeous games. It's just, I don't know, even now I don't appreciate them as much as I appreciate Sunshine and 64, but I appreciate them a bit more now that I've played one again. I'm sure I'd appreciate the Galaxies a lot more if I played two, because it did improve a lot of things. I wonder why they didn't make a third one, or like some form of Mario sequel for the Wii U. I don't count 3D World as a real Mario game, not a real 3D platformer adventure Mario going around collecting stars. I just don't count it. I count 3D Land on the 3DS to be its own Mario title because it literally is. It's its own Mario title. And 3D World, yes, it's a Mario title, but it's not the console establishment. It's like the Wii U lacks a real Mario game, and to be honest, one of the reasons why I bought a Wii U was for a Mario game, and I'm really disappointed. I've been on edge about buying the NX for a long time, since its reveal, and I predicted what they were gonna do with Zelda long before they even hinted what they were gonna do. I called that they were gonna delay Breath of the Wild to the NX and do what he did with Twilight Princess. Twilight Princess was meant to come out in 2004, and it didn't. It came out in 2006 on the Wii first, and they're gonna do the same thing with Breath of the Wild. And I honestly wouldn't be that surprised if they give us a Mario game by the first year end. So like at the end of 2017, I wouldn't be surprised if we get a Mario game on VNX. But I don't know. I don't know if I want to buy another Nintendo system right now because it's like I'm so disappointed with the Wii U. I don't have that many games for it because there is no not many games. I have Pikmin 3, Smash Brothers, Mario Maker, Mario Kart 8, What else do I even have? There's Super Mario Bros., Nintendo Land, and Wind Waker HD, and Twilight Princess HD, and it's like, two of those games are ports from GameCube titles. And that doesn't fill me with a lot of hope for BNX. But I really hope they make another Mario game like Galaxy, or like Sunshine, or like 64, where you go around collecting 120 stars, because these things are really fun, and it will make me want to buy a Nintendo system. It's been a really good game thus far, but it's not the end, regardless of what the credits say, because I'm gonna have to go back and collect the Purple Comets, as it kinda just said there. So I'm saving the game. The game is being saved. Hopefully my recording is fine too. Sometimes it's a pain. I don't know how to describe it. Sometimes it's really annoying. So this is my play file. The other one was a copied file to test that stuff. So anyway, we're back here, and the Power Stars aren't complete yet. There's 22 left. If we went into one of these, like the terrace, and if we go into one of these very quickly here, we'll notice that there's a purple coin, comet in orbit. Now I'm gonna do one really fast because this one doesn't take that long. It's only been 22 minutes of the video, and after this one, and I guess the Luigi star that's on the Good Egg Galaxy, we can call it a wrap for this video, since like the Center of the Universe stage took up so much time. Anyway, we land on this planet, not a starting default planet that we normally do, just because this is where the coin trail begins, I guess. So we're gonna go down here, pick up all of these. I think there's like 20 or something on this planet. That creates one of these 20 stars. It's basically just a tutorial level for what we are doing with the purple coins, I guess. I mean, it's a really simple one. It's just, I guess, to get you into collecting the purple coins. I mean, we've already technically done one, the flying one. However, this is where they basically make you combat to all the main galaxies and get the rest of the purple coins and such. So as you can see, there's just a bunch on the little mini planets inside of the galaxies and whatever else. I believe I don't need to land on that planet, and I can just go over here. So there's 20 left. I don't think there are that many places left to go. I'm just collecting the star bits because I can. There's none in the center because you can't get to it. There's some right there, but I see that streamline. So we're gonna land on this. Oh wait, maybe that's what I did wrong, is that I should have went in that mainstream. I see what's happening. Okay, so I'm gonna go back around again. And go back up this lane until we get to this planet again. We're gonna land on here, and I guess I may as well get the rest of these star bits. I was actually hoping I could just hit one of these, but I'm not going to bother in case I accidentally kill myself, which I wouldn't be surprised at myself doing. Then over here, I think there's no way this is a full lane of 20. Yeah, there's 10 left. Not really sure where the rest are right this second. I feel like I've been on all the asteroid sides. I could be wrong. I'm gonna get an Invisswing Star, though, wherever it went to. Oh, it's right here. It's weird, I didn't think I was gonna have issues with this, but I'm gonna look around, I guess. In the solar system, and I don't see any around me. Oh. Just gonna get back down again and, go back into the Swing Star, which is over here. I feel like I'm missing a planet, and it's pretty dumb that I am. Oh, I just never took off in that Swing Star. Never mind, that makes sense. I can get a OBG one really fast. That won't take very long. Sorry about not being able to fight that one very quickly. I just didn't go around all the Swing Star belts. The star is on this planet, right? No, it was on the main one. It's not on the egg. I'm just being stupid now. The humidity today is, like, ridiculous. It's actually very off-putting in some regard to even concentrate properly. Like, I feel like my train of thought is just all over the place because of it. I don't know why it's so strong here, like, today. I couldn't deal with living in an extremely hot part of the world every day. Like, this is ridiculous. I'm melting as it is. Okay, we're gonna get to 100 because that's a really good number to leave off on. So she's... Oh, never mind. The letter from Luigi, and yeah. Basically, we have to go to Good Egg Galaxy again and view him, or go speak to him and get a star from him really fast. So that's what I'm gonna do. I'm just gonna go over here really fast and go and back into Good Egg Galaxy and grab the star from Luigi. So just gonna quickly pick here. Fly to the galaxy. It's the first star, I believe, and it tells you anyway. It's the one with a question mark above it. Yeah, the first one, Dino Piranha, and he's apparently this is the gimmick. He's stuck in the galaxy, and you have to go save him. Now, the problem here is that Luigi actually isn't stuck. He's right there, and to get him, you're meant to go through the pipe, but you can actually just do this. How could he not leave? I don't understand. He wasn't in any danger. And he has the star. And the only thing that, like, allows me to leave is I grab the star. Why couldn't he just grab it for me and bring it back? I don't understand. But yeah. That's the version for this level. It's the easiest star in the game, probably. There we go, galaxy complete, and in the next episode we're going to go around collecting our purple coin stars, which can take a while, but there is a total of 20 stars left in the game, so thank you very much for watching, and see you guys next time. Yoshi.